this video, I'm going to provide an overview of the folders in the project tree and discuss the different types of models you can build. The project tree is located on the left-hand side of the screen, and it is where the majority of Leapfrog's functionality resides. While there are a few exceptions, the project tree is generally designed such that you import files in the top folders, you build the models in the middle folders, and you create outputs such as scene files, movies, and cross-sections from the bottom folders. There are also several places in Leapfrog where you can write notes to let others know how the project was constructed. To import data into a folder, simply right-click the folder, Import. You will know there are items within a specific folder if there is a little black triangle beside that folder. By clicking that triangle, you can open up the folder to see the objects inside. Folders without the little black triangle are currently empty. You'll see that in the middle of the project tree, we can build geological models, interpolants or numerical models, combined models, and block models. Leapfrog uses implicit 3D modeling to build surfaces and volumes from your input data. Implicit modeling means that the 3D models are built in a single pass using a volumetric modeling algorithm, essentially eliminating the need for sectional digitization. Leapfrog uses the fast radial basis function, which is a fundamental advance in scattered data visualization and modeling. Models are typically initially built directly from drill hole data. These quickly generated drill hole-based surfaces and models can then be manually edited to achieve any shape you'd like using interpreted points, curves, structural measurements, GIS data, etc. Due to its implicit nature, 3D models built in Leapfrog can then be dynamically updated or recomputed to honor new drilling, saving the modeler valuable time. More information about implicit modeling and the fast radial basis function can be found online. If you'd like to learn more, here are a couple of good places to start. First, there is the implicit modeling website, or you can visit our blog for more information on a variety of Leapfrog topics. Now that we have a basic understanding of how Leapfrog builds surfaces within models, let's take a look at the different modeling options, starting with geological models. Geological models are used to model categorical data, or non-numeric data, such as lithology, weathering, alteration, etc. In geological models, you create surfaces, as seen in surface chronology, and then cut them against each other in a geologically meaningful way to produce an airtight interlocking model. As we can see in this model, we have a series of surfaces built from our drill hole data, and then these surfaces are cut to one another following the chronology we have set up here to produce a series of output volumes. Now that we've seen how a geological model is created, let's take a look at interpolants. Interpolants are used to model numeric data. This is often assay data, but could also be geophysical data, geotech data such as RQD, contaminant data, or even temperature data, amongst others. Once an interpolant model has been created, there are a number of parameters that can be modified to create a geologically reasonable model. It is important to become familiar with these editable parameters, as they are important to creating a meaningful model. In addition to the standard interpolant model that Leapfrog creates, it's also possible to create a multi-domained interpolant. A multi-domained interpolant gives the option of creating separate interpolants within different volumes of the geological model. In this case, I've created an overall multi-domained interpolant, and I've separated out an individual interpolant for my basement rocks, for my early diorite, and my intermineral diorite. Each sub-interpolant has its own set of parameters, which can be changed independently from one another by simply unticking this box. Now that we've taken a look at interpolants, let's take a look at combined models. The Combined Models folder allows you to combine models together to create a model comprising overlapping volumes. For example, if we combine a geological model with an interpolant model, the results would show where a certain rock type intersects a certain grade level. In this case, I've chosen to see where my early diorite unit intersects a particular cutoff in grade.
In Leapfrog, there are several features which can be used to help follow the process that has been taken to create models within the project. This allows Leapfrog projects to be easily audited. First, any object which has been created by using another object in the project is linked to the object it depends on. For example, my topography surface was created from this mesh, which hyperlinks down to the mesh in the meshes folder, and in turn, this mesh was created from these points. Similarly, if you wish to know what column of data was used to create a certain geological model, you can find that information under lithologies. In this case, the split dike column of data was used to generate that geological model. The same goes for checking what column of data was used to build an interpolant. In this case, we can see it used this gold column of data. Anytime you see a little black triangle beside an object, you can see the information that has gone into making up that particular object. Second, you can right-click on any of the objects to create comments about that particular model or object in the project tree. Other users can then look at these comments to check what the original geologist noted for that particular model. Lastly, you can add information about the project as a whole by using the notes object located here at the bottom of the project tree. Simply double-click on the notes object to open it and add information.